I pull up. Set for the kitchen. Let's go. Brand new Lamborghini, fuck a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Yeah. Have you ever met a real new?
In the early 1960s as a social or park games as a training technique for rugby league. It was not then viewed as a sport in its own right. It was formalized into a sport proper by the founders of Touch, Bob Dyke and Ray Bowden of the South Sydney Junior Rugby League Club. On 30 July 1968, the South Sydney Touch Football Club was formed and the sport of touch football was born. The first official game of touch was played in the league 1968 and the first official competition organised by Dyke and Bowden was held at Snape Park, Sydney in 1969. From these humble beginnings, the game quickly became a fully regulated and codified sport. It was first played in Brisbane in 1973 and had spread to New Zealand by 1975. The establishment of the first national
As I was saying, touch is now recognized sport in its own right with zeros of people participating in local, regional and national competition across the globe. This fast, simple and exciting game promotes the fundamental skills of running, handling, evasion and support play while developing basic principle of attack and defense without the fear of getting hurt. The Federation of International Touch, FIT, is the governing body which was formed in 1985, organized the first World Cup in 1991 and includes now over 30 member countries. Now, you may continue.
Thank you. Okay, now, the game has grown rapidly in recent years, especially in South Pacific and United Kingdom. Touch World Cups now attract up to 20 nations including Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, Japan, Lebanon, USA, Papua New Guinea, Samoa, England, Tali, Cook Islands, Fiji, Ireland, Malaysia, Kenya, Singapore, Tonga, Solomon Islands, Scotland, Wales, China, Chile and South Korea. So, that's the end of the rugby history. So,
why? Stop! That's my ball! That was so tiring. Do you know where we are right now? So the field is one of the things that we need to play rugby touch. The other thing that we need is a jersey with a numbers so that the players can distinguish themselves. Next, the thing that we need to play rugby touch is boot. So this is the few of the boots that we can use. Or the one thing that is vital for rugby touch is the ball that the girl stole. That is my rugby touch ball. So let's go get this. Wait, let's talk about rules and regulation.
Touch football is a simple sport that everyone can play.
You can play in women's, men's, mixed teams, or juniors.
There are 6 players for each team on the field at a time, but you can have up to 14 people on a team, and there are unlimited substitutions. The aim is for your team to run with the ball towards the try line, attempting to avoid getting touched by anyone from the opposing team. The person with the ball can only pass backwards, so when one of your teammates has the ball, try to be behind them so they can pass back to you. If you've got the ball and get touched by someone from the opposing team, you have to put the ball on the ground and step forward over it. While this is happening, the defending team that made the touch has to get back 5 metres to where the referee is before they can make another touch. If you're the teammate who picks up the ball from the ground after the touch, you're the dummy half. The dummy half should usually pass the ball to another teammate as soon as they pick it up, because they're not allowed to score, and because if the dummy half gets touched with the ball, it's a changeover. A changeover means the ball has to be handed over to the other team, and your team is no longer attacking, you're now defending. Your team can only get touched a total of 6 times. After the 6th touch, there's a changeover. There's also a changeover if the ball hits the ground instead of someone catching it. The referee may call a penalty if an error is made, such as passing the ball after you've already been touched. It's okay to be penalised. It just means that the defending team needs to retreat 10 metres, and the opposition gets to start a new set of 6 touches with a tap from where the referee indicates. To score, all you need to do is run across the try line and put the ball down on the ground while holding it before getting touched. When you score, it's called a try. One try is worth 1 point. So let's review the rules. You can only pass backwards. If you get touched with the ball, you have to put the ball on the ground and step over it. The person who collects the ball, the dummy half, should try to offload quickly. The team that makes the touch has to get back 5 metres before they can make another touch. After 6 touches to a team, there's a changeover. There's also a changeover if the ball touches the ground. The other thing you'll find out about touch football when you start playing is that it's a whole lot of fun. Go and have a try.
One semester later.
Touch!
Give me back my ball.
Aww, but
rugby touch.
You wanted to play rugby touch?
Yes.
Why didn't you say so?
Because I thought that you don't want to be friends with me.
It's alright, let's play rugby touch together.
Seriously?
Seriously, I'll call my friends.
Okay.
Truce?
Truce.
Sesama berjanji.